Hello, everyone. Welcome to TickTick. Today, we're going to share with you a very common system that can cover the needs of the majority of people. Of course, we'll also give you a detailed overview of how it works. By the end of this video, you'll be more familiar with TickTick's task and calendar modules, and you'll also glean some time management tips from it. So, let's dive into introducing this management system. We've divided the system into two folders, each containing four lists, totaling eight lists. The two folders are for managing work affairs and personal life matters separately. If you're a student, you might rename the first folder to study. Since the two folders manage different areas, the approach to creating lists under them also differs. When managing work tasks, time is often the most crucial factor. When I look at the daunting work list, I want to see only the tasks for this week right in front of me. Tasks for next week or later this month don't need my attention yet. So we can add a this week list to manage this week's work projects. The this month list is for managing tasks from next week until the end of this month. The next month list manages tasks for the next month. For tasks further in the future or uncertain ones, we put them in the further undecided list. Unlike the work folder, the personal folder is more relaxed. Most of the items it records are just to avoid forgetting, with little to no pressure. Even when you complete these tasks, you'll feel a sense of achievement and satisfaction. So, we don't need to actively avoid them. Just categorize them by project. For example, I have a separate list for my morning and evening routines, recording small events like haircut, face mask, taking vitamins, etc. For family matters, I create a shared family affairs list in this folder so we can write the grocery shopping list together. Additionally, for long-term commitments like fitness and reading, which are beneficial to personal growth, I also create separate lists for them. So, here comes the question: how do you make a system like this work for you? Step one, without a doubt, is to jot down all the tasks you need to do into their respective lists. For example, I've been dealing with a minor health issue lately, requiring me to take medicine every night for 2 weeks straight. I'll add this task to my evening routine list and set it to repeat daily until the 2 weeks are up. Additionally, I need to complete the production of this video this week. I'll add this task to the this week list. But please note, your tasks should be specific, actionable, and not too large. Therefore, I'll break it down into multiple subtasks. First, I need to write the script, then record the footage, followed by editing, and finally, post and follow up. Unlike the previous task of taking medicine, I haven't decided on specific times for these tasks yet, so I won't set them for now and will wait for the next planning step. So, how should you plan? You can set aside fixed times for reviewing tasks every month, week, and day. For the work folder, on the last day of each month, review the next month list, move tasks to the this month list, and delete any tasks abandoned for the month. On a weekly basis, during the plan day, review the this month list, move tasks for the upcoming week to the this week list, and follow the same steps as before, to mark tasks as abandoned or delete them from the this week list if they're no longer needed. Next, use TickTick's priority feature to prioritize tasks in the this week list. Priority 1 tasks are urgent and important and need immediate action. Priority 2 tasks are important but not urgent and require planning ahead. Priority 3 tasks are urgent but not important and can be delegated to others. Priority 4 tasks are neither urgent nor important and should be minimized as much as possible. Setting priorities allows for more reasonable time allocation during detailed weekly planning. For the personal folder, the process is simpler. Just review each task one by one, check off completed ones, and mark abandoned ones . After reviewing the lists, it's time to make a detailed weekly plan. TickTick has a powerful calendar view. When making a weekly plan, switch to the week view. Click on the top right corner. Then, click on Arrange Tasks. This allows you to easily schedule tasks for specific days or time slots for the upcoming week. In the Work folder, you only need to look at the This Week list. Oh, here's a little tip for scheduling tasks. Remember, we set priorities for tasks earlier? Now, from Go to View Options and set tasks to display color-coded according to priority. This way, you'll know which tasks to prioritize. When scheduling, drag tasks from the right scheduling area to the corresponding date on the weekly view to allocate time for tasks. Start by assigning dates to high-priority tasks. Then, fill in gaps in your daily schedule with lower-priority tasks to maintain a balanced workload each day. After the initial scheduling, you can visually see if your workload is reasonable each day. Of course, if it's not, adjustments can be made. This is the advantage of the calendar view. Because many of us ultimately abandon our goals due to a lack of time, having too many goals and plans but not enough time to accomplish them, it's crucial to ensure balance. If I plan to exercise 4 times a week and schedule them all on busy workdays, I can see from the calendar that it's too demanding for me. After a long day of work, I can't handle frequent exercise sessions. So, it's better to spread out the 4 workouts, 2 on weekends and 2 on workdays, making my week more balanced. Now, you might have noticed that our tasks are only scheduled for certain days and not every moment. Perhaps this is where daily planning comes in handy. Of course, for tasks with already established times, like taking medicine at 8 p.m. or fixed meetings, you can set those times when adding the tasks, which is very correct. Speaking of daily planning, you can take a few minutes every night before bed or every morning after waking up to plan your day. Simply drag tasks from the top of the week view to the timeline to divide your new day into time slots. Please note, you need to schedule important events that require high concentration during your peak productive hours, while less important tasks like replying to emails should be scheduled during your low efficiency periods. As for when your peak productive hours are and when your low efficiency periods are, it varies from person to person. For example, I'm highly focused from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m., but the opposite is true after 4 p.m. So, I'll handle tasks like scripting the video from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. and responding to user comments and recording needs after 4 p.m. Following this plan, we allocate each task to a specific time slot, also known as time blocking, to prevent excessive investment in unimportant tasks, thereby ensuring more reasonable time allocation. Now, all tasks are scheduled and we've essentially completed the workflow introduction. Finally, let's elevate the aesthetics of your calendar together. How to make your calendar display in rich, vibrant colors is a question many beginners encounter. Earlier, we set tasks to display in color according to priority from View Options. To make tasks more colorful, we can also set them to display in color according to List or Tag. However, since the tasks in the weekly calendar view come from the This Week list, setting tasks to display by list will result in a monotonous color scheme for work tasks, making it difficult to distinguish between tasks like meetings, emails, and reports. Therefore, we can choose to display task colors according to tags. Now let's go back to the task model and set up some tags first. These tags will not only categorize tasks further, but also add richness to the colors in the calendar. For example, I can create a parent tag work and then create subtags like meetings, emails, reports, etc., and assign different colors to each tag. Then add corresponding tags to tasks. For personal tasks, you can use the same method to set up and add appropriate tags. This way, you'll have a beautiful calendar. Of course, when scheduling tasks, I still recommend switching task color display back to by priority. This will help you prioritize urgent and important tasks, making your time allocation more reasonable. That wraps up this video, where we've detailed how to manage work and life with TickTick and demonstrated the workflow. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. If you want to learn more, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more practical tutorials. See you next time.